Hello there, I'm Shahzadul, and in this video we will talk about how to write files using MATLAB. In our last video, we used MATLAB to generate 3D coordinates of FCC copper lattice, and in this video we will take those coordinates and write them into a file that can be read and using LAMMPS and Ovito for further analysis, for simulations. So let's get started.
So this is where we ended the last video. It will be linked somewhere here or here. A card will appear. You can watch that if you haven't already. And leave a like down below. I really appreciate it, and subscribe. Thank you. Now, so we want to now write these coordinates into the file, right? Okay, so we executed up to this line, line 47 in the last video. Now the rest of the lines I will execute now. So if we want to know how a LAMMPS data file looks like, for example, this is a LAMMPS data file opened in Notepad++. As you can see, the first line is a file comment, and then the second line says the number of atoms. So there are this many atoms in the structure. The third line says the how many atom types are there, one atom type or two atom types in this case. The fourth line says the lower limit in x direction and the upper limit in y x direction, fifth for y and sixth for z, and so on. Then there's a line gap. Then you say the masses of, let's say, type one atom, in this case two atom types, so type one, type two masses, and then you have atoms, and then the coordinates start. Now here, as you can see, the first line is just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So the first line is called the atom ID. So you just assign an ID to each atom serially, one by one. Then the second column is the atom type. Here, all the atoms, in our case, all the atoms will be type 1. But in this is one, there were two atom types. So maybe some will be type 2 and the others will be a type 1. And here you can see the third column is X, then Y, then Z. Okay, so that's the structure of a LAMMPS data file. So I already know the coordinates. Now I want to write this file from MATLAB. So the first thing I need to do is I want to have the first column. The first column is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And it goes up to the last atom, right? Now, I had X is my X coordinates, Y is my Y coordinates, and Z is my Z coordinates. So if I go 1 colon length of X, because length of X is obviously the number of atoms I have, right? So I have 261,856, so 261,856 atoms. So I need a number going from 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 261,856. That will be my first column. So that's atom ID. So atom ID will be that. So I will just execute that. And then the next line is atom type. Now all the atoms on the second column. Now I'm trying to make the second column. Now all the atoms will be the same type, right? So I'm using the ones function. What the ones function does is, if you write ones of 2, 1, for example, it will make two rows, one column of ones. If you write ones 2, 2, it will make this matrix. If you write ones 2, 3, it will make this. I think you get the point, what ones does. So I'm making ones length of X, so a column vector, comma ones. Now what this mkdir function will do, it will create a folder called LAMMPS run. Now if you keep a look on the left side, you will see that if I go to the next, if I execute this line, mkdir LAMMPS run, you see LAMMPS run folder has been created. And we can see it here, a LAMMPS run folder has been created, it's an empty folder. Now the next line, what this will do is, it will, I'm just assigning the name to a variable. So I want the file name to be LAMMPS run slash structure.lamps. So the address slash this. So that's just file name. And then FID1 is equal to fopen file name comma code W. That's how you open a file for writing in MATLAB. So if I use maybe FID1 is equal to fopen file name comma, if I had wrote R here, that will be opening that file as read-only, but now it's W, so that's opening this file as write-only. Okay, so as now if we go into this folder, we will see that there's already a file, but it's a blank file, 0 kilobyte. It's a blank file, but it's about to be written. Now this first line is fprintf fid1. So the syntax for fprintf is something like this. Fprintf, you can see this syntax right here. So file ID, the first command will be file ID, and then will be the format specifier, and then the variables. So let me explain what the format specifier and variables are. So FID1 is just the file ID, and then the format specifier. So I've already written this long comment for the first line of my structure file. File comment, structure of copper, comma, lattice constant, equal to %g, xlen equal %g, ylen %g, zlen %g. Now, why am I doing this? Because it is a good practice to write down some information about the structure file in the first line of file comment. No LAMMPS or Obito, no one will read that line. It's just for the user, you, to keep track of which structure file is which. Now, what are the format specifier? These are this %g are mainly the format specifiers. So as you can see, these are %g. So this %g will be replaced by, the first %g will be replaced by this variable, latp. The second %g will be replaced by this variable, len, xlen. The third one, ylen, and so on. And then at the end, you have \n. This just means enter, like go to the next line, new line. This just means new line. So if I execute this line, you will see that in the LAMMPS run folder, you can clearly see, yes, one line has been written. This whole line has been written. And you can see lattice constant is equal to 3.61. I did not write 3.61. I wrote %g, latp. And similarly, xlen 100, ylen 100, zlen 300. Okay. Because that's the xlen, ylen, zlen that we had given input. So the next line will write the number of atoms. As we remember, we need to write the number of atoms. So we write the number of atoms. Let's go to the next line. So, and if I open it again, you will see that the next line has been written, the number of atoms. How did I write that? %d atoms \n. So that's another new line, but %d atoms. %d is for integers. Use %d for integers and use %g for almost generally everything. I could have also used %g here, that's not a problem. %g is kind of universal. Okay, so what this does is atom ID end. So it takes the last element of atom ID, which is basically the number of atoms, and puts it here. I could have also written length of X here, that's the same thing, but I use this one anyway. And then fprintf fid1, one atom types, because I only have one atom type here, that's another line. And then fid1, now the X low, X high, the minimum value of X and the minimum value of Y. So for the minimum value of X, I use %f, that is a float. So I use float for very long decimal values. Again, also could have used %g here, just showing the different possible format specifiers. %f, X low, X high, \n. So this %f will be replaced by mean of X, and this %f will be replaced by max of X plus latp/2. Now, this is a little complicated, but if you're familiar with LAMMPS and Obito, you will know that Obito treats every file when it's given as input as periodic boundaries. So it considers the last atom in X direction and the first atom in X direction from this, like it considers them next to each other. So you should leave a little bit extra space after the last atom up so that Obito still recognizes it as part of the structure. Because if I had just made this max of X, then Obito will think that, okay, these atoms are overlapping, so they are probably not the part of the FCC structure, and that may cause some problems. So that may cause some problems in Obito visualization, that's it. But if you do not use periodic boundary conditions in your LAMMPS simulation for this one, then you don't have to worry about it. That's just a side note. Let's get back to where we were. So Similarly, we do the same thing for mean of y, max of y, and we do the same for z. And we just leave an extra line. Right? So if you now go and open this, you will see, let me close the previous screen. So you will see that, yes, indeed, the x low, x high, the y low, y high, these lines have been written. And now if I go to %s\n masses, I'm showing you here another format specifier, which is %s for strings. So I gave %s and then wrote masses here. This this has some uses, but you could have just written masses directly here. That will also do the same thing. And %s\n space, so this is just an empty space, printing an empty space after masses, and then mass equal to input. So it's again asking for the mass of the atom. Now, as we know, we are using copper, so I will give the mass of copper, which is mass of copper atom. You can just Google the mass of copper atom, and 63.546 U, atomic mass unit. So it is asking me in atomic mass unit, so I will give it an atomic mass unit, because we need to write it in atomic mass unit for LAMMPS and Obito. Then we go to the next line. So this line, we can see backslash t is a tab. So backslash t, so two tabs, and then one for type one, and then space, %12.8 f \n quote comma mass. This %12.8 is another a little bit more about format specifiers. So 12.8, what it means is that there will be two digits before the decimal, eight digits after the decimal. Okay, so if you see the mass line printed here, so let me open that again, and you can see, yes, it printed two digits before, and then it made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 decimal places after that. So that's 12.8 f. And then we have fprintf, fid 1 atoms \n, so just atoms, enter, and then \n again. And now the interesting part, now the main part of the code. So if we just look at our progress so far is this. This is our progress so far. Now we want to write the atoms, right? So these are the lines. Now the new line is also here. So here I want to write the coordinates and also the atom IDs and atom types. So for this line, you see I have used FID1, comma quote, %d%d%f%f%f \n. It's very important that I use either %g or %d for the first two, because MATLAB, because LAMMPS and Obito requires that the atom IDs and atom types be integers. So it's best to use %d for the first two, and then %f% 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 for atom type, for x, y, and z, because these are floats, these are decimal values, and then \n, so enter after each. I need to write each row and then go enter to the next row. Right, you see, this is really neat that you would think that maybe a loop is required to write all these coordinates, but MATLAB's vectorization ensures that you don't have to do that. If all of them are vectors, MATLAB will automatically do that for you. For example, atom ID, so all of my atom IDs, that is 1 to length of x, all of them are actually vectors. So the first one that I'm using is atom ID, and the second one is atom type. So atom type was also a vector, right? So atom type was also a vector with of 261856 by 1. So all of them are 1 actually. And then x, comma y, comma z. Okay, so x coordinates, this is also a column vector, x is also a column vector, y is also a column vector, and z is also a column vector. So if I execute this line, you will see it takes some time, because this is not just one line, a lot of lines are being written. And this method of writing in multiple lines is much, much faster than using a for loop. Okay, because MATLAB uses vectorization to write this. And you can see that 261856. So 261,856 lines have been written in just a fraction of a second. I didn't even edit this part out of the video. Okay, so that's because it's that fast when you do vectorization. And then fclose FID1, so it just closes the file so that the file can now be used by other softwares. So if I step into it, my code is officially complete. Now that we have made the structure file, we can use Ovito to visualize the structure file. Let's go to Ovito. We can just drag and drop this file over there, and you can see here it is. FCC copper nano pillar. All right, so it's 100 armstrong by 100 armstrong by 300 armstrong, or 10 nanometer by 10 nanometer by 30 nanometer copper nano pillar. Okay.
In my next video, we will write a LAMMPS input script for carrying out a tensile test on this copper nano pillar structure that we just made. So subscribe and turn on notifications if you're up for that. That's been it. If this video helped you, I request you to gently hit the like button and follow my research work on ResearchGate, linked in the description, and follow my socials, also linked in the descriptions. Check out more MATLAB tutorials on the channel. And that's it. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.